Welcome, everybody. Glad to be here in Pittsburgh, back in my old hometown. I want to thank Heather and Pat and EJ for their hospitality. We have our COO and Vice President David Epps here, and Matt Garvey, our Vice President of Communications. And really wanted to take those guys to a Pittsburgh experience. So we took them over to Permane Brothers last night. They had Permane's Brothers and an Iron City. So they can say Yinz guys for today. I told them only for today. They're Pittsburgh people. So, and also Yinz guys, thank you so much for the weather that you delivered today. In the mid 40s in Pittsburgh in December, having grown up here, it's great. So, and Yinz guys will have, that just broke the world record for press conferences, of Yinz being used in a press conference. Yinz guys will have 72 degree temperature in Mercedes-Benz Stadium. So I know you're going to enjoy that being on the sidelines for the game. So we're really excited about having Pitt come to our game. Obviously, ACC champs with the record being 11-2 and the opportunity to win a 12th game, which has only been done in 117 years at the University of Pittsburgh playing football. That's amazing. And that team won the national championship. So this team has a special opportunity to win 12 games, only the second time in 117 years, and finish in the top 10 in the nation. So pretty special opportunity for the University of Pittsburgh. Obviously, the players, we talk about Kenny Pickett and Jordan Addison and Kenneth Walker. You saw during the award shows being named to All-American teams and winning Johnny Unitas Awards, winning Walter Camp Player of the Years. We have probably some of the best players in the country playing in our bowl game this year. We've been rated top four bowl games in the country, so we are really excited about this matchup and the opportunity to host Pitt and Michigan State. I'll tell you a little bit about our bowl. We are unopposed in a TV slot on ESPN at 7 o'clock on December the 30th, so it should be a huge opportunity for viewership for our game. The Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl is one of the most competitive bowl games in the country. Of our 53 games, 53% of them have been decided by a touchdown or less. So we typically get highly competitive games in the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl. We've sold out 22 of the last 24 games, and we think this is going to be a sellout as well. We'll pay out $6 million per team. $4 million will go to the team and to the bowl pot for the conference. $2 million will go for team expenses. We're an interesting bowl. You know, we were the ninth bowl that was created, and we were created for charity. Most bowls, the rose, the sugar, the orange, the cotton, they were all for tourism, bringing people into town during the holiday season. We were created with charity in mind, and we're the most charitable bowl organization in the country. We've given $58.2 million out since 2002. That's way more than any other bowl's ever given out. And we're excited today to announce for Heather and Pat that we're going to commit $100,000 to an endowed scholarship to the University of Pittsburgh for playing in our bowl game. It will go into the John Lewis Legacy of Courage Scholarship. It'll be endowed for underprivileged kids to come to the University of Pittsburgh. So again, part of our mission is to give back, and we do so humbly with that. The other thing I'd like to mention is, out of that $58.2 million, we recently donated $20 million to Children's Healthcare of Atlanta to eradicate childhood cancer. We wanted to find trials and drugs that would be approved ultimately by the FDA to find a way to eradicate childhood cancer. And so we have seven trials now that are in process. And believe it or not, one of the trials is associated with the University of Pittsburgh. It's for solid tumors, and it's an opportunity to kids that have had solid tumor problems with cancer to help them with their survival rate. So neat tie-in here with Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl and the University of Pittsburgh doing something back in to help kids at the Children's Hospital of Pittsburgh. The last thing I'd like to do is to talk a little bit about fan engagement. We'll have about 35,000 people at our FanFest prior to the game. You see our team walks, and we're creating something new. I don't know if David, if we can put it up on the board, if we got the QR code, but we've created this fan engagement opportunity. And so if you download this QR code and send this out to your fans, we've got an opportunity for people to play games on their phones and win trips on Delta, win a trip to the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl next year, where we'll host the national semifinals with either number one against number four or number two against number three. They've got a variety of prizes they can win. So if you download that QR code and send it out, fans can start playing games on their phones. Secondly is Coach Narduzzi has been nice enough to work with us where he is actually playing the game as well, and we are going to donate $5,000 to his charity if we can get 5,000 people signing up and downloading that QR code. We have a race between Pitt and Michigan State going on. They got a little bit of head start because we had our press conference yesterday, but Pitt likes to play from behind. Coach Narduzzi's a defensive guy, so he likes that. So please put that out to all the fans. It's a neat way to engage with the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl, win prizes, and do something good like give $5,000 back to Coach Narduzzi's charity. So with that, I do have business to do. I'll do two parts of business. One is I'll invite Heather to go to Chick-fil-A. That's good for a free Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl sandwich.
Really twisting our arms here.
Yeah. Make it, I'm bribing you before.
Yeah.
And secondly is I have the official invitation letter to give to Heather that I hope she doesn't turn us down now since we're at the altar here. So here's the invitation. Welcome to the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl.
Thanks, Gary. Thank you all. Well, we proudly and humbly accept the invitation, and we're glad to be at the altar with you, Gary, Dave, and Matt. Thank you for coming to Pittsburgh and welcoming, you know, getting us this warm welcome down to Atlanta. I will tell you, you know, our team is incredibly focused, and this was their goal, you know, to win an ACC championship and to be in a New Year's Six Bowl. It's a real privilege and an honor to do it with all of you. You know, we're glad to hear about the background and the purpose behind the Peach Bowl. I know our fans are more than excited. I don't know if you can get a flight to Atlanta now, so people are just going to drive and get there. But there's a lot of people. We're grateful for Panther Nation and the Panther Pit and all those students that are coming. So I know that we're going to have an extraordinary time in Atlanta. I know our student athletes are going to be hosted to the fullest. And, you know, the memories are, I think that's, you know, at the end of the day, we've had a lot of individual success on these Pitt football teams. You know, unbelievable individuals who've gone on and had great NFL careers. But this year's team is about a tremendous senior class and a team that when you look at, you know, Coach Narduzzi's hashtag, we not me, it is about the we. And they did come together and win a championship that that was their goal. And so I think the memories of that championship coming to the Peach Bowl, to the caliber of bowl game that this is going to just solidify that memory that much more, not just for the team, but for all of Panthers. So we're really grateful to be a part of it, and just want to thank everybody. And all right, get on the QR code. I don't like to lose to anything, so we got to get on that to the Panther Nation. So we'll do that. And again, just thrilled to be coming, and we know Atlanta well, but this will be a different. We'll have a longer stay and a lot more time to enjoy it. Thank you.
Coach, coming.
Sure. You know, as head football coach, I couldn't tell you how excited we are. I've known Gary for a long time, and we couldn't be more excited. You know, I don't know if anybody knows this, but Gary took a little visit to Pittsburgh midseason and came through our facility. We spent probably a half hour in my office during the season, and I think this was destiny. I think that's where we were planning on going. You know, in 7 years here, he hadn't come to my office until then. I usually go see him in Atlanta, but he was here. So our football team is excited. You know, they haven't played in a bowl game of this size, this magnitude. It's something when they see that video, which they'll see it Saturday, I think they're going to get cranked up. You know, we've already started preparing for a great Michigan State football team, and, you know, Pitt will be ready. But we're excited. It's going to be a heck of a week. You know, can't thank you enough. So, hail to Pitt.
All right, we've got time for some Q&A. You guys want to ask some questions? Either Gary or Coach?
Or Heather.
Or Heather.
Heather, obviously. Anybody?
Gary, I'll get with you, Jerry, on the QR code. I'll help you out with that after we get done. I'll help you out, my man.
Jerry's already playing the games, man. He's
no. Look at that little recorder he's got right there. Works. My man. I'll get you with that. Get your cell phone.
I was wondering, Pat and Heather, if you thought about the historical perspective of this Pitt season. You know, Gary mentioned 12 wins would be the most ever since 76. What this means to the legacy that you might leave here and what it means to the future.
Yeah, Jerry, we've talked about it a lot as a football team. It's kind of been my motto as we went through the season. It wasn't focusing on, you know, gosh, we clinch, you know, the Coastal today. You know, we're going to, you know, be ACC champions today. It's been 1-0 and talking about getting the next win. And that kind of, to me, has fueled things as we've gone through. And, you know, we know, I think we're one of four teams to win 11 games. And if we win, you know, against Michigan State on the 30th at the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl, will be the second team in Pitt history to win 12 games. And I think, you know, when our young kids think about history, they don't kind of go back, but when they hear about something like that and they can say we're one of two teams to win a dozen games, it's hard to do. And, you know, as Heather mentioned, you know, we've played together as a team and nobody can do it without each other. And I think, you know, coaches and players, quarterback with his receivers in the O-line and running backs and et cetera, et cetera. So, you know, it is history being made. And, you know, when I got here, I knew we could win championships. We've won 9 national championships. I think things come in circles and it's coming back around to where Pitt is very, very relevant. And that's kind of why we came here. So it's exciting.
Jerry, I'd just add that what I love about it is there's no question the individual success of individual players, but the fact that there's not this feeling of, you know, jealousy. I mean, they are all supporting one another, and I love that fact, and I love the fact that the current students at Pitt have a memory of being a part of the Panther Pitt when this team won the Coastal here at Heinz Field. Then they all went to Charlotte to be a part of that ACC championship game, and they're all going to Atlanta to be a part of this Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl. And those are the memories that connect people to Pittsburgh and to the University of Pittsburgh. And, you know, when I talk to alumni and donors and unbelievable fans that we have, you know, they reference the past a lot, and because it's so historic, right? I mean, the players, I mean, we were just with Tony Dorsett and Kenny Pickett, and, you know, it's amazing. But this is about today and the future, and I think you're right on. I mean, this program, it takes time to build it the right way. We have unbelievable confidence in Coach Narduzzi and our staff, and they're building it. And here's where, you know, this is just the start of where we're headed, so.
Awesome. Other questions?
Yeah, Heather, I mean, you talked about the flights, and I don't know if you can sort of quantify or maybe just talk about the response you've gotten so far from the fan base as far as interest in attending this game and excitement and that kind of thing.
Yeah, the phones are ringing, the emails are flying. So I would say that there's great demand, and obviously Atlanta's a destination place. It's easy to get to. It's there's a ton to do in the city. So I think it's a place that our fans are, we've got a strong alumni base there too as well. We recruit in this area. So it's a win-win all the way around, and there's definitely a high demand. You know, we know that the airline market is a little bit lessened since COVID, so the flights are fewer, and they're frankly all gone if you're trying to get there a day or two before. So come a little early and stay after the game, but people can drive it, which is nice as well. So high demand, and high demand from our student population, which is great.
And we will play Sweet Caroline in the third quarter. So,
how are you managing the time between games, and what's the experience like for your team to prepare? And we're still 2 weeks and 2 days away from the game.
Well, the first thing is, you know, I've been a part of, you know, different staffs where I think you went into a bowl game and the kids started to get bored with the game plan going into game week. So that's the first priority, is just to give them a little bit of the game plan as we go. You know, we're in development mode right now. You know, we'll go out Saturday and get some development in, but we want to make sure that they're, you know, not so, you know, when we get to Atlanta, they're not bored with the game plan. And, you know, we're not going to have long practices. We're going to be sharp. We're going to be fresh, and we're going to be fast.
Are you able to do much this week or with
finals?
Yeah, Chris, it's been our norm here at Pitt that during finals week, you know, that we're focusing on finals, so we don't practice at all this week. The kids are welcome to come and watch tape and get involved with their coaches if they want to. But, you know, the priority is finishing up our finals strong. We want to be a champion in the classroom as well, and then we've got plenty of time to get prepared for the next game.
You said the team's excited, but obviously Kenny has said he's not sure if he's going to play. I know Mel said yesterday he's not sure if Walker's going to play. How do you kind of, I guess, sort of jive those two things? It seems like most of the players are excited. There's definitely some guys that have a decision to make about this game.
Yeah, I think, you know, everybody's got a business decision to make. You know, not everybody's going to agree with decisions, you know, that I make or Kenny makes or anybody else makes, but they're business decisions, and we all have to respect those decisions for whatever they are. We all know what we'd like, but you know, not everybody in this room has to deal with the consequences of playing or not playing. So those are big boy decisions, and as soon as I know something, I'll certainly let you guys know. The night before the game. be a good time.
Pat, has there been any decision made yet on an interim offensive coordinator for the game?
No, I have not decided that yet. We're kind of getting through recruiting tomorrow, and then we'll start to dig into that. Good to see you, Craig.
It's good to see you as well.
I can hardly tell with that mask on.
Time for a couple more.
Heather, is this season kind of what you foresaw when Pat got his extension after the 2017 season? And then on that, I guess, do you foresee another commitment in that regard to Pat moving forward?
Yes, it is what I believed we could do. You know, when you look at the schedule out, obviously we're very involved in scheduling. This is the first year of, you know, the schedule that we put together, Pat and I, and there's no question I had confidence. You know, you look at the that they could run, you know, make a good run this year. And so I'm not surprised one bit. And then, yeah, I mean, Pat and I will work on, you know, his arrangement and deal, and we are, and we have. So when we're ready to able to share that, we absolutely will.
Speaking of recruiting, what's it like trying to sell yourself to offensive players when you don't have an offensive coordinator in place? How have you kind of negotiated that?
Well, you know, history repeats itself. Back in 2017, we had this young quarterback from Ocean Township, New Jersey, that was committed to us, and we didn't have an offense coordinator. We didn't have a quarterback coach. And, you know, and I mentioned it the other day, it came down to trust and loyalty, and that quarterback was obviously Kenny Pickett. So Kenny came here in January, enrolled, which would be, you know, January 10th of this year coming up, and he enrolled and had the faith that we were going to do the right thing. And I say we because, you know, all those decisions are made by the staff together. And as far as, you know, who's going to lead that offense and who's going to be that quarterback coach. So it just comes down to trust, and it comes down to relationships that you have with the players. And if they don't trust you, then, hey, probably better off. And if they trust you, we'll get the right guys here.
Coach, in addition to all that you've and the team has accomplished this year, very historic, very awesome, and also playing in this great bowl for you, is it any nostalgia, special feeling to play against a team in which you've served defensive coordinator?
It really is. I mean, it's another game, and I'll say that. But, you know, to go up against the green and the white, as they call themselves up there, it's exciting, really is, because you've got some familiarity. I really don't know the kids. I mean, it's been, you know, 7 years, so it's everybody's new. You know, a couple of the coaches I've got a long, long relationship with. So it's fun to go up against, you know, people that you know. I'm glad I don't have to go up against Mark D'Antonio, I can tell you that, just because of the, you know, the love we have and the relationship we have. That'd be hard to see him lose, okay? It'd be hard to see me lose for him. So you're glad you don't have to go against, you know, best friend like that, you know, with Mark and Becky. Just, you know, someone you spent 11 years with. That's a long, long time. And it's not 11 years, you know, we see each other every other day or, you know, once a week. Like, it's 24/7. So that's the good thing about it. You know, if it was Mark still being there, you know, it'd be a little bit harder to chew into. So it's exciting.
I could look it up. Are there any guys in the depth work with at Michigan State?
Yeah, Harlan Barnett. I know you like to go back. Harlan Barnett was my secondary coach for the entire 11 years that I was at Cincinnati and Michigan State. Ron Burton is our D-line coach. He's there as well. So those are the two main ones as far as the coaches that, you know what we do defensively. They know signals. They know some things. And, you know, obviously we have some changing to do, but we got plenty of time to fix some of those things.
If I can take the liberties, we were at Michigan State yesterday doing the same thing with our press conference and our invitation, and I can't tell you how many people came up to me and said, knowing we were coming to Pittsburgh, and said, say hello to Pat Forrest and Coach Narduzzi. He's well-respected up there, well-liked, so I can only imagine what he's going through playing against his old his team that they had so much success up there. And if I can secondarily take the opportunity, there's not two nicer people in the business, and I've been in this business 24 years, than Pat Narduzzi and Heather Lyke. So you have some real special people here at Pitt, and you can understand why they're such a successful football program, and I'm sure what Coach Capel's going to do in basketball and on down the line with Heather here now. These are very respected people in what they do, so you're blessed here at Pitt for sure.